Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls and everyone in between, welcome back to The Witcher. You join me, McReeps Geralt, bunch of dead bodies, and John Luke, the... Oh, what's her name again? Mrs. Bobo or whatever, I don't know. Yogi Bear's little assistant anyway. We found out they were having some secret little affair. We've got the evidence. I wonder if we're going to out her. I don't want to, because I mean, she's got that twat of a husband. She deserves a little bit of farmhand action. Okay, we'll take all of this. God, can we not? Excuse me. Can we not get up here anymore? Geralt, go. There we go. We did it. Nailed it. Oh, that's cool. No worries. Right, let's do a little jump job over here. We're live streaming on Twitch, so when I respond to people, I can't do what now? I can't claim? Yes, we can. Yeah, I don't think I've gone crazy. It's just I'm answering people in chat. And so we're going to hop up here, go speak with the contract giver, which is just the biggest, most arrogant wine merchant that you will ever know. He's a horrible guy. I wonder what's going to happen. I wonder if we're going to have the option to out their little secret affair that's kind of blatantly obvious, right? The way she spoke about him. This is a pretty nice old vineyard, honestly, during the day. Nighttime it was pretty scary. But in the day, it's a very nice. Okay, dude, where you at? I do not want to pull one over on you. Gotta be up in the main house, right? It can't be in there. That's his cellar. Witcher or not, you've still to bust your bum. Oh no, he is. He's still in the cellar. What the actual buggery are you doing down there, man? Okay. Mr. Pompous.
Fix it by the end of the day.
Wow. He's slave driving. For real.
You, can we talk?
Yes, I love the fact that Geralt's so blunt with him.
You're best preparing good news.
Oh.
Get on with it.
Stab him. No. No, we are not.
Got rid of the beast that was giving you trouble.
Not our possession to tell him.
Shelma? Whatever could that be?
Kind of like a cross between a mole and a caterpillar. Just big as a barn.
Huh? Well, Master Witcher, you make a poor first impression, but ultimately proved your worth. There. Your reward.
As for Jean-Luc, afraid he's dead. Sorry.
Who? Oh, him. Trivial as losses go. I shall soon find another to take his place.
Oh my god,
right.
I hate him.
After all, he is just a peasant, not a monsieur de blah blue blah.
Monsieur de blah de blue blah blah blah. Come on, can we not go speak to her?
Focuses foundations. It's why things are toppling.
A blind giant, this damned beast. Meandered all about.
Quite a bit of stone and brickwork awaits.
That it does.
Okay, well, I mean, the peasantry know exactly what was going on. He's got no idea, though, has he? That's just typical of the world. Where is she? I really want to speak to her and be like, there's your locket. Take your money back sort of thing, but I don't know if we're going to have that option. It kind of sucks. Oh, is this her? That's just noblewoman.
Greetings.
Where's Mademoiselle blah 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 blah? Where is she? Is she up here? Oh, she might be inside. No. Damn. I feel like we missed a trick. I kinda wanted to see where that story would unravel to, but Are you okay? You know where the lady of the house is? No idea. Oh, there she is! Hey! Found your thingy.
Have you found him?
Mm-hmm.
Found this.
Jean-Luc?
Sorry. Really, I am.
She's nice. She's a nice person.
Lock of hair inside. It's yours, isn't it?
Yes. Jean-Luc and I... Well, I'm certain you've pieced it together already. I thank you for your discretion. For avenging him. Please, it's terribly modest, I know, but... You must take this reward. My husband is certain to be miserly with his gold. Now, if I may, I'd like to be alone.
Thank you very much. See? A little bit of discretion goes a long way. Oh, I think a bird shat on your face. I'm really sorry. But they say it's good luck. Bless her. Cries milk. Okay, so now that story's all tied up. I'm really happy that they let you do that. I mean, there was no little objective to go and hand that in, was there? If there was, I didn't see it. Because I may be a blind man. Secondary quest, not yet. We're going to finish these contracts. So we have this one. Go talk to Count Belladal. Is that one? Oh yeah, that's the guy that we took walking around everywhere. And then we got the Bovain Blues. So we'll get these done. And then it's been suggested that we go and do... Turn and Face the Strange, which is the letter that tells us about Professor Moru. The one that Yennefer sent is. The Witcher mutations and all that sort of stuff. So that's what we'll do as well in this episode. Hopefully we'll get it all done anyway. We don't know if these are going to like string out to anything extra. This one's just to collect your reward, so we should be fine with that. We are going to go with the optional peruse the exhibit. Oh, of course, yeah, because this guy had his photograph hat thing going on, right? His memory snatcher catcher. So we'll go see what he actually took pictures of, which will be amazing, after he blinded us against our first encounter with the giant centipedes. And then we'll talk to him. Sweet. Good idea. I think they're both roughly in the same location, so... We'll do the fast travel job to get over there. What's this? Hold on. Boink. Why is it pointing me there? Oh, because I've put that silly point on the map. Okay, it's done. I really want to go to the pub as well. We've not been to the pub for a long time with Geralt. We never really get a drink. Goose. I watched Fly Away Home the other day with the wee man. Couscous. I'm not saying couscous. Which is awful, by the way. Let's do the old fast travel. Boom. Done. I keep forgetting that when you hover over that sort of thing, it gives you a little information snippet now about the place that you're going to. So we'll start reading those. And get a little bit more flavour text about what's going on. In fact, we'll see what this one says right now. Because why not? Francolatz. The Corberta... Why did I say? The Carolberta Woods are named after the Toussaint's reigning duchess. Grandmother, Duchess Carolina Roberta. Who loved organising elaborate games of hide and seek in this forest. A small trapper's post located on its outskirts has grown into a tranquil village known as Francolatz. Here, hunters, woodcutters and beekeepers come to sell the fruits of the woods. The village springs to life once a year when the Baron Trastamara organises his annual wood festival and invites all to the court to a spectacular hunt. Wow, I wonder if we get to go on that hunt. That'd be pretty amazing. Do they all have flavour text, actually? See, I never noticed this before, but maybe if we go back to the other places. Lebioda's Gate. Yeah, that's kind of cool. We'll read it next time we go somewhere. I can't remember that being in the base game. Maybe it was, maybe it's always been there and I've just been so ignorant. Don't talk to him yet. Oh, jeez. Let me have a look at your exhibit. Oh, they're amazing. Look at us. We are action heroes. True, full on, out the way, lady. Full on action heroes. Oh, that's when we released the panther. Geralt and a panther. They're pretty good, aren't they? So he painted these. Hey, can we get out of there? Thank you. Geralt and the giant thing. How did he get in on that? The White Wolf taming Buclair. No, we did not. We did not tame it. We slaughtered it. The first selfie ever. And he's got the pout going as well. That is fucking awesome. Hey, no, why?
Female Beauclair centipedes are formidable predators. The beast preferred to hunt in packs. Yet the author of this extraordinary work was able to capture a lone specimen preparing to attack. Cast your eye on the hunter, who, though fully aware of the danger, wears a look of cold determination on his face as he awaits the optimal moment to strike.
Ah, Geralt, you're here. Wonderful. Come, please.
Oh, did I not look at the last one? That sucks.
A small gift for you, and I shan't let you refuse.
I won't. Give all of the gifts that you want to give. That's pretty awesome.
Thanks.
Geralt and the Peacocks. The White Wolf by Count Bedal. Bedal. How's your daughter doing? Is she okay?
Talk to your guards back at the camp. Told me about Clarissa. Sorry to hear about her accident.
Thank you. Kind words that mean a great deal to me.
How's Clarissa these days? Probably can't wait for you to get back.
To get her gifts, you mean? I've dispatched two already. She'll not need to wait for my return. En route home, I mean to pass through Dol Blathana. They say one can see Sylvan's there.
Yeah,
don't do it.
Actually happen to know one. Name's Torque. He can be mean, but for the right fee, he'll do anything you ask.
Splendid. I thank you for the hint.
Tell him I send my regards.
Boom, we're hooking him up with contacts.
Good crowd. You got a lot of friends. All of them seem to be fawning over your paintings, too.
Oh, when you have as much coin as I do, friends buzz around like flies on fresh meat. And they praise you to high heavens for each trip, burp, and sneeze. Not all are lying sycophants, that's not what I mean. Just most, unfortunately.
Why bother? Why even invite them around?
I'm a man of enterprise. I must put my trade before any personal hatreds or sympathies. Besides? At times, I'll exhibit a completely failed painting. Just to listen to them twist their tongues into knots, trying to find just the right superlatives to lather on smeared rubbish. Naturally, the more intent someone is to get into my good graces, the louder they praise my masterpiece. It's devilish fun, I tell you.
I like him. He knows that they're all pompous twats. He must have come from nothing. And the fact that he's doing that for his daughter so she can see the world, kinda commendable. Farewell, nice man.
So long now.
At first I thought he was a bit of a dick, but first impressions and all that, right? A witcher taming the peacocks. That's awesome. I want that. I want a picture like that, for real. Get me playing the Witcher taming the Weacock. The Weacocks? Hey, the Weacocks is a whole different type of person. I don't want a picture of that. We will take this because we are the hunter. We've been hunting. I love the music here. I could literally just sit here and listen to the whole thing. Players of the one and only true Gwent. One and only true Gwent wanted, no, that cocksucking Count Monier. insists on fucking up Gwent, so I've decided to say fuck him and organise a tournament of my own. I can't promise y'all money is finery, for I ain't as rich as that bastard. Ye can be damn sure, however, that unlike Moniers, we'll play the one and only true Gwent, with no shitty Skellige faction. Oh, them fighting words, Yaki. I've seen ghosts, announcement from the Ducal Guard, armour at your service. Hey there, knight. Looking for damsels in distress, and an announcement. The answer is no. Wait, have we missed conversations going on? I like coming back here and seeing what sort of nonsense is happening in the village. Because it's all situational. Like, you do a quest and something might be there. Like the Gwent thing. So we've already killed Striggan here. I wonder which one's in that other place. You think it's Loth? Or Philibert Fourfingers? Somebody has to be in that hideout where we got one-shotted. I don't know if I started recording before I was talking about this, but up here. Hans. Now Hans isn't on any wanted posters that we've seen so far. I wonder if that's the four-fingered guy. Where was we going to go next? Oh, we did that one, so the next thing is another witch contract. Hand in this one, collect her reward. Should be fairly close by, I'm thinking. That's not fairly close by. But we'll pop over to the quarry. So every man, be he tippler or teeter tottler, knows that Toussaint's economy steals from the fruit of the vein. Or stems from the fruit of the vein. Few, however, realise the Duchy's lands are rich with deposits of slate and other valuable building materials, and that quarrying of such was once the bedrock of local livelihoods. Thus, when God-fearing Toussaintois saw fit to build a statue of the saintly Lebioda, they had no need to send for the materials from abroad. Instead, they merely reactivated Ardiasioso. Amazing. Hey, why can we not fast? Because we're not at a fast travel point. This is probably a good reason why we can't fast travel. I always forget. Other games spoil me where you can just fast travel from anywhere. I kind of like the fact that you can't in The Witcher. It's nice that they're there, but you don't need to be... you need to be at each point before you can fast travel. More games should be like that. I would normally do the run job over there, but I don't want very many cuts in this video. Hokey dokey. And it means I get to take a sip of tea as I'm fast travelling. Very British. Who's no longer in the EU, by the way. Happy trumpet noise. Now it's going to get some hate from you. You stares, you naysayers. Shouldn't really talk politics, should we? Politics is a terrible subject to get in on. People's opinions, people get salty. I'll shut up about talking about politics right now. And get back to talking about the politics of filling my purse. Come on, you. Figure out your bovine blues.
Well, have you learned how that cow came to fly?
Mm-hmm. Everything's been cleared up.
Yeah, you can get back to work. And it wasn't a plague of falling cows.
Did I not say so from the start? A weight off my chest. So what was behind the animal's plummet?
Young slizzard flying over the quarry dropped it. Was trying to get it back to its nest, food for its mother and siblings. Probably heard the last of the beasts. Burned the nest, eggs, everything.
A praiseworthy precaution, but as I said, I can only pay you what we agreed. I simply haven't any more.
That's okay.
Here, take this. And I thank you, Master.
God, are you sneaking more crowns to me? You're a lovely person. What was that all about, though?
All cleared up now, right? No gods, no plague, just the dragon, but it's gone too. We're to pay Emile's widow compensation, and that will be that. So, why do you still stand there and wait, man? Back to work! Chop, chop!
And I've a notion suspicious workings are still afoot. What became of the builders who were to put the statue together? They were due 3 days back, yet there's still no sign of them at Ardesto.
They were crushed too, I'm certain of it. Or eaten, or locusts got them, like in Zerikania.
What's this rubbish you spout now? The architect wrote they would arrive a week late with a large shipment of marble from Metana for the prophet's beard. So stop flapping your yaps and get to work! Allow me to walk you away, Master.
Oh, he's going to tell me that they've not received a letter and we've got to go look. You watch. Mark my words.
I lied. But I cannot have them panic again. The workers he mentioned, they've indeed vanished. Come see me later. I shall divulge to you the details.
Boom. I am a detective. And a very stylish looking detective. We've got the professor's glasses on, if you haven't noticed. If you haven't noticed, are you even bloody watching the video? Come and talk to him again. Oh, big feet you fell. Can we... I didn't want there to be another quest. Talk to the foreman at Ardesio? Is that what you called it? Ardesio. Oh, I think we should do this one because we're here. But I really want to get on with that one that I said, Turning Faces Strange. Dilemmas, right? Dilemmas indeed. We're right here though. So we'll do this one very quickly. Super quick. Probably not super quick. Out the way, dog. Seriously, dog? Oh, we're stuck. We can't get down the stairs because of a bloody stupid dog. Found my only weakness.
So, Master, the workers who vanished. How goes the search?
What do you mean? You never told me to look at you. You told me to come and talk to you.
They vanished? What's that mean?
Just that. Along with ample supplies. I had placed an order. More than a dozen wagons reached the building site, yet five were lost along the way. Tools, food, building materials, and first and foremost, the specialists we need. The chief architect included. I wrote to the architect to say the quarry awaits. He should send new plans. But the foreman said the architect was here, at Ardaiso.
And Ardaiso?
He's missing too. Got it. I'll look around, see what I can learn.
Master, I know not how to thank you, but I beg you to hurry. We shall simply not finish without those five wagons.
Owl, five wagon you, don't you worry. So, locations marked on the map indicates place where transports carrying materials needed to finish. St. Lebiodis statue, our engineers responsible for its construction, have run into trouble. We've already done a few of these, actually. Oh, okay, so the first one, that... One group of people was just getting drunk on the beach, right? And they beat the shit out of me. I mean, I destroyed them, obviously. Don't go check the episode. I can't remember what the other ones were. I think one got stuck with the arch spore and all that sort of stuff. We can go back and check. Or you can go back and check. See the wee videos, maybe. So provide them with aid and watch as you help erect one of the wonders of the world. Let's do it. I'm certainly all there. Visit the building site. I wouldn't mind doing that right now. Or maybe we do that afterwards. Pretty sure. Roach, don't come down here. There's the wrong button. Have a look at our map. That's cool that they've marked it now though. So. Big feet fell. You can go check that out first. They're all very close to there. Okay. So Prophet Lebiodis' statue during the reign of Duchess Carolberta, Toussaint was visited by a certain disciple of the Prophet Lebiodis named Plegmund. That's not a nice name, is it? His words and the deeds, which included miracles, were so persuasive, so nearly the entire duchy had converted to the new faith. They crowned this outburst of religiosity, oh my good god, with the construction of a temple dedicated to the prophet. But that was not enough for old Plague. He decided, he convinced the Duchess to build a statue of Lebioda, the lakes of which the world had never seen. Oh, please, please be in the pose of Christ the Redeemer. That would be amazing. Probably not going to happen, but I really hope it does. Because they just talked about his crazy beard, right? His big marble beard. That's very Christ the Redeemer. If it's in the shape of Christ the Redeemer, I am going to die. Because that's a big old risk to take. There's two things you don't talk about without getting slammed by someone. That's politics, which we've already encroached on. And religion, which this game just kind of, it mocks everyone equally, so you can't get too mad, right? Let's-a-go! Lebioda! I would move to Toussaint in a heartbeat if it was a real place. Sphincter poppers and all. What's the name? Spelchers? Slizzards. Slizzards and all. Which are kind of sphincter popping, because I would poop myself if I seen one of those flying around. Loading times, what are you doing? You catch me drinking my tea every single time. Hey dude. Don't patrol on an empty stomach then, you just stood there. Can't say patrolling on an empty stomach hard work when you're literally just standing there. Oh my god, it is going to be, isn't it? Oh my good god. Where's your hands at, dude? Where's your hands at?
Impressive.
Oh no, his hands are going to be at his side. Are they? Oh, I don't know, there's something jutting out the top up there. It's kind of impressive, and it's somewhat on a little raised section. Oh wait, is it already on the minimap? Is his hand going to be out here? Kind of looks like it is going to be, so he's going to have one hand out and then the other across the front of him. Minimap, you spoiler bastard. Okay, let's go check out the locations of these chaps. I mean, while we're here, we can always hit up these as well. Maybe not that one. In fact, no, we won't hit up any of these. We'll just go to where we need to go for today. Be on our best behavior. Let's wait until daytime so we can see. Let's go. Oh, who's a bad guy in these parts? Arrest warrant in accordance with this, blah blah blah. Loth, son of Mark, alias Halfbreed. Oh, he's a handsome chap. Good strong jaw. The guard brings peace to our domains. Okie dokie. Oh, this is not a good place to be running around. I know it's going to pop up here. Bugger that, get back on the road. On the road again. Avoiding all the art spore on the road again. Not very far away, we're not going to bust the roach out. Don't think. Oh wait, are we even going to the right one? Oh, we weren't. We were going to the opposite one. That's fine. Well, we got to go to them both eventually. Just see my little marker going up. That didn't seem right. Do the quick save. What's going on, people? Oh no, is that blood?
Just wonderful.
I know, that's exactly what I was thinking, Geralt. Don't you worry though, Sunshine. We got this. We can be style. We can set them on fire. Get out of here, wolves. Oh, we set a dead horse on fire. A little bit brutal even for us. We're doing a grand job here. Are you still on fire over there, dude? Whoa! Hey. Calm yourself down, Smokey. Okie dokie, let's start with the dead horse.
Smashed bones. Damn, it was strong.
A troll, maybe? Got big feet. As does everything in this DLC. Oh no, wait, there. That's Shalemar tracks. Is that Mummy Shalemar? Is there more to this story? Hey. Okay, what's going on here?
Damn, ripped to shreds.
Examine it, Geralt. It's a big old bloody footstep.
Deep prints, blood. Just trying to get away.
Wait, so they're attacked. Ah, it's the workers that are trying to get away. Okay. Keep on going. Keep on keeping on, Geralt. More blood. You not want to mention anything about the big Shalemar footprint, honestly?
Damn it.
Wait, it was a Spriggan? That doesn't look very Spriggan feet-ish. Okay, so I got that completely wrong. It's a bloody Spriggan. Hey, no, we don't want anything to do with that. I'll bust you up. You've got no idea what's coming. I didn't mean that, I'm sorry. Okay. We need to get a Spriggan fight going on. I forget what he is. I think he's a relict? Maybe? Let's have a look. Oh, Spriggan, are you in here? Yes, you are. Okay, relict oil, fire, obviously. What's this? Dimeritium. I don't get the dimeritium thing. I don't like using the dimeritium bombs because it means I can never bloody heal myself. So, we gotta go with the cheap ass relict oil. Get you going. I'll take a white Rafford for now and a blizzard. And we're gonna go nuts. Let's go. Get a Petrie's filter. Get Origni on. Hey. You got no idea what's happening, Sunshine. Hit me all you like. It doesn't hurt. Not even one bit. It does really bloody hurts. I'm not gonna tell him that though. Not gonna give him the satisfaction. Sit down, Sunshine. What have you done with my workers, eh? Okay, you buried them, that's fine.
Come out. I'm not gonna hurt you.
Thank you, Sir Witcher. Let Beota keep you in his care.
Mm-hmm. We need you to finish the beard, boys. Oh, we called it. We knew all about it. They're the arm specialists. Excuse me, will you stop? Will you stop transporting me across the world when I could have picked up some Spriggan guts? I guess we'll just have to settle for the blossom. Roach, that's a nice statue though, right? You enjoy it? We're doing fine work here. have got no idea where we're just where. But we're close by this place, so we might as well just take a gander. What's going on?
Come on.
Hello? Rot fiends. Oh, necrophage stuff. Let's go. Let's go, rot fiend. Boom. I can't remember what they don't like. Probably fire. Go away. Get. Roach, look out. Oh, there's some explodey stuff happening. Come here, buddy. Not your house. You're not welcome here. Oh! No! Oh, that was a close one. Boots are away. We're all done. We'll need to quick save. We've not saved for a while. That was a bit risky. It's a lovely day in Toussaint. Not a bloody cloud in this. Never mind, there's plenty of clouds in the sky. Should have looked before I started talking nonsense. Hello? Can we come in? Nope. Hello? You got. Just a bunch of wolves. We're okay. Oh, wait, this is Augustine? I'm thinking we've read about him at some point. A key to the chest in sunflower fields. Sweet. Let's learn about this. A thick journal written in a steady hand. The last pages, however, contain different handwriting, full of blots and crossed out words. A mysterious gentleman has come to me asking whether I would agree to sell him the stock of barrels we are preparing for the new wine variety. I refused him curtly, for I know how much the new wine means to Miss Matilda. And how much depends on this wine success. After all, things have been very tight at the vineyard these last days. This extremely mysterious gentleman has turned out to be equally extremely wealthy. He came to me again with a very hefty pouch. Bum blast it. It will be very hard to refuse him if he puts me to that trial again. Today, I forgot to lock the gates to the barrel storehouse. I'm very ashamed, but what can I do? Miss Matilda is crushed. I won't touch that coin until it's all settled down. I've hidden a sack stuffed with Nilfgaardian florins in the sunflower fields. I would not want someone to find such a fortune in my home. He's paid me another visit. This time wanted me to procure him the recipe for the new wine. I do have some honour. Barrels are one thing. I can make new ones, perhaps even better ones. But the recipe for the wine? I'd sooner die. Then he gave me this strange look, sent shivers down my spine. I think I'd best barricade the doors this night. Who is this? So some Nilfgaardians come? Nilfgaardian that's into the wine. Have we met any of that? Don't take candy from strangers. Oh my god, not another quest. What are you doing to me, game? We obviously have to finish that. Go find it. Can't be far away. Holy shit, it's far away. Roach, come with me. Daddy doesn't want blisters today. On the road again. Riding on my... Roach, what are you stuck on? Stuck on a fucking flower? And I know the game made a jest about getting stuck on things, but that doesn't mean hang us up on everything. Ooh, hold on. So, this is Spriggan area, right? This is where the...
Come on now.
No, don't come on now yet. Where did
Not
we kill...
So fast, Roach.
Where did we kill Mr. Spriggan? We followed it up this way. Right, we followed it into the woods. Nope. I'm lost. I'm so lost. No idea. Those Spriggan remains will forever just be there, rotting away. Let's go. What a day in Toussaint. Right. Sunflower fields. I know it's a good sunflower when I see one. This is no sunflower field. Oh, that's a sunflower field though. Hey, get off your horse. Let's go. So, oh, I thought that was like a freaking snake or something. It was just a hissy cat. Oh, he did a really good hay job here. 70, that's a good price, are you kidding? You sold out for 76 florins, my god. What is wrong with you, man? It's a buyer's market, obviously. So, we're not going to go do that one just yet. We're going to carry on with the big old footsteps. Where is it? Big feet to fill. Sold. We've only got one more to go, and that statue will be done. Done and dusted. We are so far away from the statue right now, though. Let's do the roach thing.
That's it, roach.
Fast traveling's good and all, but sometimes you just need to get the breeze in your hair, right? You gotta let your silvery locks flap around. So we'll do the lock flap. We'll head over there. This game just gets it all right. Excuse me, out the way. We are so stuck right now. Oh, good job. You figured it out yourself? Amazing. It gets it all right apart from the horse riding mechanics, which are a bit of a nightmare. Thank you for your florins. I wonder if we'll ever find out who the Nilfgaardian is that's stealing all the recipes. I'm thinking we might.
Damn.
Hey, what's going on here? Oh, you're the Lebioda guys. Okay. Get off my stone maker people. Oh, we need things to happen right now. So first of all, we're going to coin up. And then we're going to get ready with all of the right things, because this fight could prove to be our trickiest in a long time. We'll have everything going. We will, I don't know whether to add them to death or just set them all on fire and enjoy the massacre. I think we'll enjoy the massacre for a wee while. Give me my hangman's venom. Let's go. Set them on fire. Enjoy the massacre. Done. You guys serious? Whoa. Did you kill him already? You bastards. Okay, nice shot, dude. Oh wait, he's on our side. Okay, I love it. Great stuff. I'll take this guy then. Are you coming at me? Why are you suddenly coming at me? You're all fighting each other. Okay, who just shot an arrow in me? It's fucking rude. Oh no. Wait, the arrows are coming from everywhere. Take it, bandit. Yes. So where's the other guy? No! Oh no, that's bad. Bad juju. Okay, coin up. Got him, dude. I'm on it. Oh, he's doing some work on this guy. Good job. Don't worry. Don't worry, boys. You don't have health bars. You'll never die. That's what we'll call you, the Never Die Crew. Oh, he will, though. I think we're done. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay, Hunter. See you in a bit, dude. Or see you tomorrow.
You would be the famous Witcher, would you not?
Exactly.
I shall hitch my wagon and set off for the monument works at once. They await me there.
Boom. Are we doing a grand unveiling at night time? Doesn't seem right. did it. Go see the foreman. Well, we shall. Can we wait till daytime just to see what it looks like in the day? That'd be kind of cool. Take all of this gear. We might be leaving the episode here. We got quite a lot done though today. Once we hand this one in, at least. Take everything, because I'm gonna go sell Happy. Sell everything to everyone. Take your potatoes, we'll take your mushrooms, we're gonna make a nice salad here, some honeycombs. You guys raid people with the weirdest shit in your pockets. Ratatouille, why not? And the statue, looking pretty awesome, honestly. Pretty awesome. Okay. We'll head up that way. Go speak with the foreman. And then we'll end the episode there for today. At least we know where we're heading though. Got a nice little vantage point. Hey, why? Why you suddenly get all dirty and misty? Foggy.
Move it.
Oh, the weather certainly changed quick. Cool though, it's really cool when it's overcast like this. It's the first time I've seen the weather like this actually. That's a great... What are you doing now, boys? You finished? You not realise you finished? What are you doing? Making boats? Maybe wood festival. Maybe it is. Okay. Mr. Architect, is it? Is everything okay? Everything to your specifications? Okay, he doesn't care.
Helped you finish the statue like you asked.
Master, what would I have done without you? Countless throngs of Lepiota's followers will praise in prayer.
And you'll pay me, right?
But of course, your reward. The Infesta is a serious man of enterprise. Our plan foresees mass conversions. With the donations that will follow, we aim to recoup the costs of production in 3 to 5 years. Everything has been calculated, you see, down to the last decimal.
Good luck then. Farewell.
Yeah, profit-free organization, the old faith, right? Wrong! Biggest money spinner ever. So let's... What do we have now? That is a pretty awesome statue though. I wish the minimap didn't spoil it for me. Sneaky bugger. But, still looks pretty cool. We've got most of the things around here done. We've got a couple of question marks. We're not going to do any off camera. We might not do them all, but every one that we do will be on camera. Just because, like, this one turned into that little mini quest, which was kind of intriguing. We know there's an Nilfgaardian running around buying up recipes and assassinating people that are good at making good shit. So that's a thing. Are we going to go there next episode? No. Next episode we're going to start on another secondary quest, and it's the one that we was going to go do. Turn and face the strange. So thank you very much for watching, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, let me know down in the comments. Until next time, as always, take great care of yourself, be good, be safe, and I will see you in the next one.